Good evening. Good evening, son and daughter of God. The video starts now, and let's all stand and greet our brothers and sisters in the temple. Amen. With smile, with gladness, and with joy. Amen. As we sing this song, oh how good it is.
Thank you.
But as we worship you, Lord God, you will be the one who will be enthroned. You are the one, Lord God, who will be lifted up from this time, Lord God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sing the song.
It's all about you, Jesus. for the breath that we breathe, Lord. Thank you for all the blessings that we receive, God. Here we are tonight, Lord, not to seek your hands, but to seek your face, oh God. We're here, oh God, to thank you for all the things that you've been doing in our lives. Indeed, God, words are not enough to give you thanks. Our words are not enough, Lord, to praise you, to worship you, God. That's why in our hearts, Lord, tonight, offer a sacrifice of praise. Let our hearts, Lord God, bring you the kind of worship that you've been looking for, oh God. Lord, tonight, may you find this place, oh God, hearts that are hungry, hearts that are thirsty for more of you, God. Hearts, Lord God, that will only be satisfied in your presence alone. God, tonight, we just want to thank you. Let this night, Lord, be a night of thanksgiving for all the things that you've been doing in our lives, oh God. And Lord, we pray, oh God, as we study your words, continue to be with us. Let our hearts find rest in your presence. Let those weary souls, oh God, find strength in your presence, oh God, tonight. Let your words continue to encourage your people. Strengthen, oh God, those weary souls tonight, God, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Lord, continue, God, to empower your servant, whom you're going to use, Lord. Speak more of your anointing, more of your power, more of your presence, Lord, to manifest through him, oh God, that he may be able, oh God, to share your words, oh God, clearly, with love, oh God, with compassion, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. And let our hearts, Lord, tonight be receptive. Let our hearts, Lord God, accept your words wholeheartedly, oh God, of the things that you want us, Lord, to learn tonight, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. Be free to move in this place, Holy Spirit. We just entrust you this very moment, oh God. We pray, oh God, that your spirit dwell in this place tonight. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we give you praise, we give you glory, we honor you. In Jesus' mighty name, this is our prayer, and everybody say, amen. Amen.
Praise God. Good evening to everyone. Are we all blessed?
Amen.
Amen. We are waited so many moments, amen, to came to this day. And of course, welcome to one another. Should we give a smile to the person next to us? Say hello. How are they? Amen. So are we all ready to receive the very message for us at this time? And of course, without many things more to say, I want to introduce our beloved pastors. He is always our longing to be with him, amen, at this very special day and very special season. So, Director of International Operation po in Europe 2, none other than our Reverend Pastor Benny Alcantara. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise God. Again, good evening to everyone. Let us give our God the best clap of praise. Are we excited tonight, people of God?
Amen.
Amen. We also are excited to be with you. This special moment, celebrating, of course, on Sunday, the 16th anniversary of the JIN Church here in Denmark, Copenhagen. And of course, in behalf of our spiritual bishop, Brother Eddie Villanueva, our spiritual director, and the international president of the JIN Church Worldwide Ministry, and Dr. Adoracion Villanueva, the vice president, and of course, the beloved of our spiritual director, Bishop Brother Eddie Villanueva, si Dr. Adoracion Villanueva, and of course, with the JIN Europe Corporation, with my eldest son, Pastor Benji. We would like to greet everyone, JIN family here in Copenhagen. Warm greetings. I believe God has prepared something greater upon each one of you.
Amen.
So congratulations for your tirelessly and unceasingly service to our God. Amen? Amen. Are you excited tonight, people of God?
Amen.
Again, every time that I stand here in the pulpit, I always say to our brethren to expect greater things from the Lord. Because I believe our God is unlimited God.
Amen.
Amen. We have all the reason to be excited. Amen.
Amen.
Especially if you love the Lord our God. Who among us here really love the Lord?
Amen.
Can you see that hands of those who truly love God?
Amen.
The Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, and no mind has conceived what God has prepared for those who love Him. Amen. So every time that we came here in our worship service, always have in your heart a passionate love for God. Amen. Because that is what our God is looking for, those who are genuinely love Him. Amen. And He made His promise that those who really love God will receive extraordinary things from the Lord. Amen. And the Bible also, thank you, brother. Sorry. And the Bible declares also that if there are two or three gathered together in His name, He is in the very midst of them. Amen. So we believe that the very presence of God is in this place.
Amen.
Do you believe that?
Amen.
Amen. Then if you believe that the very presence of God is in our midst, therefore we are in the supernatural environment.
Amen.
Amen. Where miracle is available. Amen. Extraordinary, supernatural is available because the very presence of God is in this place. The Bible says where the presence of God is, there is freedom. There is power. There is provision. There is life in the presence of God. Amen. So always have in your heart an excitement every time we came here in worship service. It is not a burden, but it must be a passion. Amen. It must be a privilege. Amen. To be with God. To be in the presence of our Lord. Amen. So tonight, I would like to share to all of you some formulas for church explosive growth. Because as a church, this is the reason why we exist. Amen. The mission of the Jesus is Lord Church Worldwide Ministry is to bring all peoples to the kingdom of the living God, regardless of race, status, belief, and religious affiliation, through the saving, healing, delivering, and transforming power of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. So this is the reason why we exist as a church. Amen. And of course, we must equip our people. Amen. We must transfer the passion in serving God. That's why our vision is a glorious church. Evangelizing, not only evangelizing, but also discipling all Filipinos and all peoples of the world through teaching, preaching, and living out. Not only teaching, preaching, but there must be also living out of the gospel. Amen. So our testimony is very powerful, as what the Bible says in Revelation chapter 12, chapter 11, verse 12. They overcome the enemy by the power of the blood of the Lamb and by the words of their testimony. Amen. So it is very important for us, our vision. So that's why we have our life group ministry, formerly like JIL 12. So our principle in JIL Life Group Ministry is everybody is a leader. So that's why we train, we equip people so that from sitting ministry, they will be involved into sending ministry. Amen. Who among of you want to serve God?
Amen.
Amen. Do you know that serving God is not our right? It is not our right because we are not worthy. It is only by the grace of God that we can serve. Amen. So serving God is a privilege. Amen. That's why service to the Lord must be progressive. Amen. If your service to the Lord is decreasing, meaning to say you are not passionately, you are not motivated to that passionate love for God. So that's why we must be motivated that our service is an act of our love to God. And of course, it is an act of our gratitude. Amen? Amen po ba?
Amen.
Amen. So, purihin po ang Panginoon. Again, it is my great privilege and great opportunity to be with you tonight sa ating gathering and to bring the words from the Lord to each one of us. Amen. So, formulas for church explosive growth. So, you don't need to be a scientist or a doctor and to understand the formula for church growth. Actually, it is a basic. So, basically, it is just a reminder for all of us. Amen. Amen. So, because there is no such formula that can be effective without application. That's why Christian must be reminded every time. Amen? Because without application, our learning is in vain. It is nothing. Amen? So, in the book of Acts chapter 1 and verse 2, well, if you will read this this whole chapter of Acts chapter 1 and Acts chapter 2, we can see that church growth started in this chapter, no? From 120 believers to 3,120 believers, just overnight. So, but that is not all. And in the book of Acts chapter 2 verse 47, it tells us also that each day the Lord added to their group or to the believer those who were being saved. Amen? And they grew daily. In Acts chapter 4 verse 4, it says that many of the people who heard the disciples' message believed it. And the numbers of believers totaled about 5,000 men, not counting women and children. So they grew rapidly. Amen. And I believe the power of God never diminishes even in our time. The only thing I think that changes is the commitment and the passion of the believers.
Amen.
That's why the explosive church growth are so difficult to see in different churches. Amen. But tonight, I believe, as we study this message, we will start to grow rapidly for the glory of God.
Amen.
Are you excited for that?
Amen.
Amen. So, in Book of Acts chapter 5, verse 13 to 15, it says also, nevertheless, more and more men and women believed in the Lord and were added to their number. So, I should say that the church experienced explosive church growth at that time. Amen. So, in Matthew chapter 28, verse 19, it says, the Lord Jesus Christ himself said to his disciples, Therefore go in all nations. Go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey. Teaching them to obey, and I will be with you until to the end of this age. So, noong unang panahon pala, they were not counting the believers or the converts, I should say, but they are counting the disciples. For example, yung mga disipulo, nagkukwentuhan sila. Maybe they are asking to each other, how many disciples do you have? Hindi nila tinatanong, ilan na ba ang mga members mo? They are not asking members. They are asking for the disciples. Amen. Because God wants us to be disciple, all the believers, so that we can be an instrument of God to bring the gospel to all nations. Amen. So it must be a continuous cycle. It continues sa parang gulong. Hindi siya natatapos, tuloy-tuloy, until the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. So, it will be a big question mark if the word or the message of God that you receive will stop onto you and you will not share it to other. No? It will be a big question mark. Kasi how about the others? After 2,000 years, pagdating sa'yo, huminto na yung gospel. Because you neglect the Great Commission. Amen? So, sadly to say, there are many Christians are still members of Tunganger's ministry. Tunganger's ministry. So, the Lord doesn't want us to be a member of the Tumangers ministry. We must be from sending ministry to sending. Alam niyo ba yung Tumangers? Baka ako lang nakakaalam. Amen. So, I want to share four vital keys I observe in our church group. So, what I will share to you is our practical experience. No? This is a practical experience. This is not a doctrine, but based on our experience in Italy, so this is the key that we observe why we experience church growth. So, in Italy, we have 59 churches. Wow. 59 churches in Italy. In Milan, we have 19, where our main office held. Now, we have 19 churches, and we have an average of, in Milan, we have an average of 2,000 members. So, we experienced this church growth because of this formula that I'm going to share to you. So, I believe it must be also our desire to grow because our God is the God of progression. Amen. See, He is the God of progressive. He is a progressive God. So, He is not the God of digression. Nagdi-decrease, pababa. Amen po ba?
Amen.
So, number one church growth formula is passionate love for Jesus. Basic yan, di ba? Napaka-basic lang yan. Pero, basic nga siya, if hindi natin ito, if we will not apply it in our daily life, so, passionate love for God or for Jesus ay hindi natin na ipakita, hindi natin na i-apply. So, sabi nga ni Apostle Pablo, faith without work is dead.
Amen.
Is dead. Amen. So, kaya kailangan na it must be seen in our lives. Amen. But if you are deeply in love for somebody, it is obviously na you can observe that person is in love to somebody. Especially when that person will see that somebody, you can see her eye or her or his eyes twinkling. Twinkling. Because in love. Amen. So the same thing with our Lord Jesus Christ. If we are passionately in love with Jesus, when we will talk about serving God, it is our priority. Amen? It is not a secondary thing in our lives. It is a primary thing in our lives. If we are truly passionately in love with Jesus, that's why it is one of our core values. Passionate love for God. Amen? So, it must be seen in our lives. We must desire to serve and to be used by God. Amen? Amen. So, we must be more than willing to give the best and the holiest for our God. Amen? But hindi po yung leftover, yung tira-tira. Amen? If we are passionately in love with God, surely we will give the best. Amen? We will give the best effort in serving Him. Because we are passionately in love with God. If you are deeply in love to someone, you are available, you are willing to give your best just to make that person happy and content. Tama ba? Parang marami nakaka-relate sa akin. Ano? Of course, especially sa ating mga loved ones from the Philippines, we are here because we love them. Amen? We came here because we want to give a better future for them. We want to make them happy. So the same thing with God. Amen? The same principle. So, serving God must be our passion. It must be a primary thing in our lives, not secondary. We will not just give our leftover time or strength. King Solomon says in Book of Ecclesiastes, the last chapter, sabi niya, in conclusion, the whole responsibility of a man is to fear God and to obey His commandment. Amen? And of course, we will be rewarded by the Lord. Amen po ba?
Amen.
So, one of the best example in the Bible is King David. He became a man after God's own heart because of one reason. Because he will do whatever God wants him to do. Amen? Question. How about you? Are you willing to give your best for God? Like King David. In 2 Samuel chapter 24, verse 24 says, but the king replied to Arauna, no, I insist on paying you for it. I will not sacrifice to the Lord, or I will not offer to God, to my God, a burnt offering that cost me nothing. Amen. So, this is one of our expression in giving Him our gratitude of what He has done in our lives. From darkness, He brought us into light. Amen? From nothing, He made us somebody. Amen? Mula sa dilim, dinala po tayo ng Panginoon sa liwanag. Amen? So that's why it must be our expression of love. Amen? In serving Him. So, passionate love for God is expressed so many ways. So, in worship, in prayer, in giving. So there are many ways to express our loves to God. The most important thing is let us express it. You cannot just put it in your heart, say that I passionately love God with God and doing nothing. Amen. That is not love. Amen. Sabi nga, hit us. Open review is better than secret love. Diba? Amen. So, in serving God, of course, we can never outgive God. Amen. We can never outgive God. Once we give our best to God, He will surely give His best for us. If you will make His agenda your priority, He will make also your agenda His priority. Amen. Because God is more generous unto us. Amen. Mas alam po siya sa atin. We can never outgive God. If you are generous, He's more than generous. If you are faithful, He's more than faithful. Amen. So we can never outgive God. Hindi natin sa pupending lamangan sa pagbibigay. Amen. So that's why on our own personal experience in serving God, I personally learned to give my best in serving the Lord. Even it will cost the future of my family. Amen. I still remember way back 2006 when we first acquired the first property of the JIL Church in Milan. It cost 2 million euro. 2 million euro. And imagine, our congregation on that time was only 200. And we are about to acquire a property that is cost 2 million euro. When I was about to sign the contract, I said to the Lord, "Lord, as I sign this contract, even the future of my children is already, you know, kumbaga sa ano, nakataya na lahat dito, pati future ng aming mga anak. But you know what? God is faithful. Yung first acquisition natin ng church building, ito yung naging starting point for greater move of God, for the greater expansion of the church. So from 200, we grew rapidly. You know, we became 400 just in one whole year. And the Lord supplied the monthly mortgage. We have a 15,000 euro monthly mortgage at the time. You see? So it was really amazing how God provided us, you know, the monthly mortgage. And that was 2006. Now we are in 2016. After 10 years, we have already acquired 6 properties in Milan, in Italy, for the glory of God. Because we want to give our best service to God. So we acquired two buildings in Milan, one in Bologna. In Bologna, it is a 3-story building with a total of 1,200 square meter total space area. Way back 2009, the market value of that property was 1.4 million. And you know what? We acquired it last year just for 600,000 only. 600,000. So God is really amazing. So He did not just provide our financial needs, no, but He also increased even His pay more upon us. Could you imagine from 1.4 to 600,000, almost 800,000 discount? So that is how God amazing. Amen. In the book of John chapter 5, 1 John chapter 5, verse 3 to 5, this is love for God, to obey His commands. And His commands are not burdensome, hindi kabigatan. For everyone born of God overcomes the world. It's the victory that has overcome the world, even our faith. Who is it that overcomes the world? Only he who believes that Jesus is the Son of God. So, if we are motivated with that passionate love for God, 100% we will give our best. Ngayon lamang po, presently, we have another project in Milan also, near of our church in Milan, in main office. There is a building, four-story building, with a total of 11,000 square meters, and it will be a apartment. It will be an apartment. Apartments, 100 apartments. Ang plano natin na gawin doon, it will become the GIL cornerstone in Milan. At medyo malaking challenge to, because you know it is a 21 million project, 21 million euro project. It will surely give the highest glory and honor to our God. It will surely exalt the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And at the same time, it will also benefit the people of God. Amen. Because that 100 apartments will be available for our, brethren who are who wants to acquire the property, to have their own home. So, without any down payment. So, the reason why we want to take this challenge is because we want to put a big logo on the rooftop of that building, four-story building. Jesus is Lord. So we want, because we want to exalt the name of Jesus. So we want to express how God good in our lives. Amen? So, without any fear, of course, medyo kinakabahan din naman. At 21 million ba naman yun? Pero we believe that we can never outgive God. Amen? So, if those things became possible on us, it will also become possible to you here in Denmark. Amen. Just passionately in love to our God. Amen. Amen. Eh, pagka nga yung mga guwapo-guwapo dyan, di ba? Nailan tayo. We are willing to give everything. Lalo po si Lord. We must give everything to the Lord because we owe everything from Him. We owe our lives to our God. Amen po ba? The church growth formula number 2, praying leadership. Ayan. Can you ask your neighbor? Huwag mo muna siya titigan. Nagpe-pray ka ba? Tanungin mo nga siya. Are you praying?
Are you praying? Yes.
Are you praying?
Okay, the Bible says that, of course, the backbone of the church is prayer. Church without prayer is powerless. Amen. In the book of Acts chapter 2, verse 42 to 47, we can see here that the disciples were devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and to the fellowship, to the breaking of bread and to prayer. Everyone was filled with awe, and many wonders and miraculous signs were done by the apostles. So, it is not, prayer is not only, it's not just only the backbone of the ministry. It is also the formula for us to experience signs, wonders, and miracles. And when the church manifests this miraculous things in the church, people will surely come to the church. Amen? So that's why we need to pray. Pray and pray and pray. Amen. So in verse 47 says, praising God, enjoying the favor of all the people, and the Lord added to their number daily those who were being saved. So that's why I personally led people in prayer. Amen. So we organize many activities of prayers. We have our sunrise worship every Saturday morning at 5 a.m. So we are doing it for almost 20 years. Every Saturday morning, 5 a.m. In winter, we do it inside the church. In summer, we do it on a hill, an overview, where you can see the whole Milan. Beautiful place. Amen. And of course, we have also our daily prayer inside the church. No, the church is open every day, and we encourage people to come into the church and pray. Nung Katoliko pa kaya, nagtutungo tayo sa church, nagtutulos pa tayo ng kandila araw-araw. And why we cannot do it now? Diba? Naalam natin, the Lord is listening and answering us in all of our prayers. Dati parang bahala ka ng Panginoon, nanginginig mo ba ako o hindi? Magtutulos ka ng kandila kasi madilim. Baka hindi ka makita ni Lord. Hello? So every day, we encourage people come to the church and pray. Oh, if you have 30 minutes, bacon, in your work, you can come to the church and pray, say a little prayer. And we organize also our OPC. You know what is OPC? Online Prayer Conference. It is also an everyday prayer activity by phone. Di ba yung mga mobile natin, kung pwedeng magkaroon ng 5 person na magko-conference. So the whole church is involved in praying at 5 a.m. 5 a.m. in the morning. And then after that, you can again sleep. Sometimes somebody is, while they are praying, madidinig mo naging sa presa, telepono. Sorry. Ano nag-iilig? Tulog ka na ba yata dyan, Brad, sister? Tulog ka na yata dyan. And of course, we have our activity, yung every Tuesday natin. Every Tuesday, every Thursday, every Friday, every day, we have our prayer activity in the church. That's why, so, you know, because the bigger the church is, more prayer is required. Amen. Mas malaki ang church, mas maraming panalangin ang requirements. Amen. Because it is like a vehicle, you know. If the horsepower of your vehicle is 100 horsepower, so the vehicle can bring 1 tons of load. So the vehicle can move easily. But if you will put 2 tons, the vehicle can no longer move because the capacity of the vehicle is just for 1 ton. So the same thing in the church. If you will do a prayer meeting once in a while, so you can only bring a load that is, you know, able to that prayer once in a while. Yun lang ang kaya niyong dalhin, yung once in a while na ng prayer meeting, yung konting tao lang. So the more people came into the church, the more prayer the church need. So that's why leaders and workers should pray. Amen? Amen. So it is the discipline and commitment to the prayer that has fueled, ito yung gasolina, the growth of the church. Amen. So we have also our spiritual mapping. Our spiritual mapping is like a routine, like a maintenance. No? Maintenance, tuloy-tuloy na siya. Hindi na siya huminto, spiritual mapping. Kahit wala pang manifestation of any negative spirit, we always map, no? Spiritual mapping. Amen. So that is also our distinctive. We are a praying church. Amen. And church growth formula number 3. Equip and motivate people. Okay. So letter number 1, to commit their lives in serving God passionately. So that's why we share this experience that we have in serving God, because we want to encourage all of you to dedicate your life in serving the Lord. Ako po personally, for me, the greatest achievement in life is serving God. Amen. You may become a famous architect, well-known doctor, but all of those things are just here on earth. You cannot find it in heaven. But the things you done for God here on earth, you will find it in heaven. Matatagpuan mo pa yun sa langit. Amen? So, that's why we encourage people to serve the Lord. Wherever you are, saan ka man naroon, ano man ang status in life mo. So, just be passionately serve the Lord. Amen? Amen. Because whether we like it or not, church growth required effort. Amen. I remember that the boy who took an exam and started to say he failed the exam. So he came to his father and he said, "Daddy, I failed my exam, and my teacher told me that I failed because I am lack of effort." Can I ask you, Daddy, what is the meaning of effort? What? Daddy said, effort? You don't know what is the meaning, what it means? Sabi niya, effort natin, wala kung anong meaning. Sabi nga sa Tagalog, doon naglalanding ang airplane. Kaya pala napagsak kay Ma'am sa Daddy. Amen. So more people working for the Lord, more accomplishment. Amen. They will repeat that. More people work with the Lord. Don't work for the Lord, but work with the Lord. Because if you will work for the Lord, you will be tired. But if you will work with the Lord, He will sustain you.
Amen.
So work with God. So more people work with God, more accomplishment. Amen po ba? So, how about our Sunday service? Do we have, every Sunday, do we have visitors or first-timers? Do we invite friends, relatives, or kababayans? Or every Sunday, bokya tayo? Ano niyo ba yung bokya? Zero. Ano? So, we must grab the opportunity every Sunday to invite people. You know, don't be shy to invite people because, or don't be afraid because it is for them. Amen? It is for them. So, don't be afraid and don't be shy because you are doing them a favor. Amen? You are doing them a favor. Of course, they don't understand that. But we know that what we are doing is because we want them to be saved also. We want them to receive the benefits of what Jesus did on the cross. Amen. Jesus paid the price of our sins. But first of all, they need to accept that. They need to believe Jesus. Otherwise, it will be in vain. What Jesus will be in vain. Amen. So, that's why God is counting on you. Tell it to your neighbor, God is counting on you. Wow. Can you feel the load of that words? No? Could you imagine that? God is counting on you. Wow. The God who created the heaven and the earth. So because we are a recipient of His divine favor, we receive the grace of God. Amen. And of course, we must also give an opportunity to those people who are not yet receiving Jesus as the Lord and personal Savior. Amen. Amen. So, kailangan masipag po tayo at matapang. Hindi lang masipag, matapang din. Kasi kung masipag ka nga, hindi ka naman matapang. Hindi yung matapang ang pag-away. Ah. You must be courageous in sharing the gospel of Jesus. And if they will persecute you, praise the Lord, you are blessed. Because the Bible says, blessed are those who are persecuted because of me. Amen. Ang mahalaga, hindi tayo persecuted ni Jesus.
Amen.
Yan ang pinakamasakit sa lahat. If Jesus himself will persecute us because we neglect our duty before God. Amen. So, another thing to equip and motivate people, the divine fear of the Lord, and to be faithful in giving their tithes and offerings. I shared already this afternoon to Sister Sally, yung church where I pastor. Our average percentage of tithers is 88%. 88% ng members natin ay tithers. So we have only 12% that are not tithers because they are still new. Amen. Why do we need to give our tithes and offering to God? Of course, first and foremost, it is not about expenses. It is about eternity. Amen. We are investing in eternity. And because our church need to be supported, whom do you think will support the mission work in the church of God? We cannot expect those who are outside. Amen. That's why I told you before, God is counting on us to be faithful. Amen. Not just in serving Him, but also faithful in giving our tithes and offering to God. Amen. Because giving our tithes and offering to God will support the works of the church, will support the work of the ministry. Amen. And once we give, you will also receive. That is a principle. Amen. That's why I told you before, we cannot outgive God. Giving is the key to prosperity. Amen. God has given us seeds. Seeds for our daily eat. And He also gave seeds to plant. Amen? Di ba pagka magsasaka ka, merong binhe para pantanin? Meron din namang seeds para pagkain. But if you will eat the seeds for planting, wala ka na. Di ba? You have no more seeds to harvest. Amen. So our tithes is an offering, is the seed for planting, so that God can give us harvest. Amen. So nakakita na ba kayo, who among you remember the song of Fred Panopio? Ang kawawang cowboy, may barilo ng bala, may busa, wala namang pera, ay butas pa. Ang church na walang suporta sa mga mananampalataya ay tulad ng isang kawawang cowboy. The church was born in power. Amen? And yet, because the disciples didn't give their tithes and offerings, so the church cannot go to a place or to the mission field because walang gasolina. Diba? Kahit gano'ng maganda ang kotse ko, kung walang gasolina, useless pa rin. The same thing in the church. kahit gaano marami ang members, kahit gaano kaganda ang church, if the people are not obedient in giving their tithes and offering to God, the church cannot fulfill the mission. Amen? So, ito po yung banner ng Church Grow. Amen. So, we can see in the book of Acts, chapter 5, verse 11 to 13, this is the story of Ananias and Sapphira. The two generous but dishonest couple.
Yeah.
They are generous. Why? They sold their property. And then they gave it to the disciples, the money. But they are not faithful, no? Because they hide something for them. And yet they are telling to the disciples that they gave everything. The disciples. Sabi nung iba, bakit daw namatay si Ananias? Why Ananias died? Dahil sa pira. Dahil sa pira. Diba? Si Sapphira kasi yung asawa niya. Pero Sapphira din. Kasi they are dishonest. Buti pa si kapatid din, nabuhay niya agad din. No? Do you know that in heaven, faithfulness is always rewarded? Amen. May isang kwento ng three men who died, no? And of course, they are believers and they got to heaven. But before they entered to the gate of heaven, there was Saint Peter who is interviewing them before they can enter to heaven. Saint Peter told to these three men, okay, before you can enter to heaven, I must interview both of you because so that we can measure what reward that we can give. Kung ano yung pwede niya ibigay na reward. So the question was, how many times you became unfaithful to your wife? So the first person was interviewed by Saint Peter. Okay, how many times did you cheat your wife? How many times you became dishonest to your wife? He said 20 times. 20 times. Okay, because you cheated your wife 20 times, here in heaven, you know, the reward will based on your faithfulness. So, I will give you a utility car. Ano bang utility car nyo dito? Sa amin, Fiat Uno. Fiat Uno yung mumurahin lang na kotse. Okay, you will be... okay, you will be rewarded by Fiat Uno. And then the next one, the next man, Saint Peter asked him, how about you? How many times you became dishonest or unfaithful to your wife? He said, 10 times. Okay, because you cheated your wife 10 times, I will give you BMW.
Wow.
Okay. So so that you can roaming here in heaven with the BMW. And the last one, Saint Peter asked this man, so how about you? How many times you cheated your wife? And with his head high, he said, you know, Saint Peter, I know that you know that I am faithful. I never cheated my wife. Okay, because you are faithful, you will receive a Ferrari. Okay, so that you can roaming around here in heaven with your Ferrari. So they left, the three left. And after a few months, Saint Peter met the one who received the Ferrari. And he said, oh, how are you? How is the Ferrari? Oh, it's good. So, but it's why it seems you are lonely. Sabi ni St. Peter dun sa lalaki, no, na nakatanggap ng Ferrari. Yeah, St. Peter, because I met my wife here. She already passed away. So why you are lonely? So you must be happy because you have your Ferrari and then your wife is already here. Yeah, but I saw her riding in a bicycle. Magaling ka talaga, ano? Napalim agad. A bicycle lang eh. Okay, so of course we must equip and motivate people, ano ho, with the divine fear of the Lord and to be faithful in giving their tithes and offering. Many times we were trapped. Christians were trapped by Satan in this kind of reasoning. Anyway, God can understand me if I will not give my tithes and offering because my family in the Philippines need this amount. So instead of giving it to God, I will send it to my family in the Philippines. Anyway, God will understand me. Of course, I tell you, 100% will surely understand you. He can understand you. But God has a principle. We cannot escape the consequences. Like Sapphira and Ananias, they suffered consequences because of their disobedience. Who among you still remember the widow in 1 Kings chapter 17? Elijah came to that widow asking for a bread. Do you remember? The widow said, responded to Elijah, yes, I have only a few flour and a little oil. I will cook it and will eat it with my son, and then we are ready to die. So it is a matter of life and death. Amen? But Elijah insisted, cook a bread for me and I will, so that I can eat. But he didn't say that later on I will think of your needs. So the lady can make an argue or can a discussion with the Lord. Hey Lord, it's a matter of life and death. You see? But she made, or she chose the right decision to obey. And what was happened? Overflowing. The same thing with us. God is not asking us something just to make us, just to put us in a difficult situation. God is not like that. He wants us something from us so that He can start on that something. Amen. The same thing Moses. God asked to Moses, "What do you have in your hands?" He said, "A staff." Okay, use that staff to do miracles. So it is a corporate effort between God and man. Amen. You must give something to God. For example, you are about to take an exam and you did not study for nothing. And you prayed and you prayed and you prayed to God, "God, help me to pass the exam." And yet you did not study. So from where God will start? So at least you have to read your assignment or your tech, something, you know, you must study. So that from that, God can remind you. Amen. So I told to my youngest daughter, she took an exam this morning, and before she go to the school, she asked me, "Daddy, can you please pray for me because I will take the exam?" Okay, but first of all, I will ask you, did you study? Yes, okay, we can pray. if you did not study, I cannot pray for you to pass the exam because God will not make a focus. It is a cheating. Amen. And after 3 hours, she called me with her joy in her voice, "Daddy, yay, I passed my exam." Oh, you see. I told her, do your part and God will do His part. Amen. So you study and God will do the rest.
Amen.
So the same thing with us. Amen. God wants us to be motivated in fear to God and faithfulness in giving our tithes and offering so that He can also bless us. Amen. I always said to our workers, the maximum that you can give to others is the things that you have. You cannot give to others the things that you don't have. Amen. If you are not blessed, you cannot bless people.
Amen.
Amen. So that's why God wants us to be blessed, so that we can be a blessing for many people.
Amen.
Amen. But first of all, it must be a fruit of our obedience to our God. Amen. We are teaching people to give that tithes and offering not because of money, but we are after to their obedience. Amen. Amen po ba?
Amen.
And giving our tithes and offering to God is also an act of our love and gratitude to our God. Amen po ba?
Amen.
Amen. So in Acts chapter 2, verse 43 to 47, says, "Fear came upon every soul, and the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved." So the fear, this fear is divine fear. It is a holy fear to the believers. So in Acts chapter 43, chapter 2, verse 43 to 47 says, "Fear came upon every soul. And the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved." So because of that fear, fear to the Lord, and the divine fear to the Lord, It is a sign that the very presence or the manifest presence of God was there. Amen. The fear of the Lord is a sign. Amen. It is a sign of the manifest presence of God in the church. So that's why when the presence of God is there, there is manifestation of miracle. So that's why multitude of people were added to those who are being saved. Amen. Amen. So, in Acts chapter 19, verse 17, fear fell on them all, and the name of the Lord was magnified. Amen. So, that is the very reason why God wants us to have that divine fear unto the Lord. Amen. So, in Romans chapter 15, verse 4 says, for everything that was written in the past was written to teach us, so that through endurance and encouragements of the scriptures, we might have hope. Amen. So, kailangan po kasi tayo ay mag-endure. So, mag-endure tayo sa ating service to the Lord, and it must be a progressive. Amen. If you are active in the church at the start, and then after a few years you lay down, so something is wrong. Why? It is not a progressive, but it is a decreasing of our faith. Amen. Before, your standard in service to the Lord is too high, and then later on it fall down. So something is wrong. So our love to God must be progressive. Amen. So that we will endure. Amen. In Philippians chapter 1 verse 6 says, he who began a good thing in us will bring it into fulfillment until the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. So, this is the desire of God for all of us, that His plan for us, every detail of His plan for us will be fulfilled, will be completed until the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. But it will only happen if we will continue, if we will endure. Amen. Praise the Lord. And last but not the least, number 4 formula, a confidence in the Holy Spirit's work. Amen. Not by might, not by power, but by the Spirit of God. Amen. So in Acts chapter 9 verse 31, the churches were edified and walking in the fear of the Lord and in the comfort of the Holy Spirit were multiplied. So, dito po makikita natin that conversion growth is a supernatural event. Amen? It is not us who born again people. Hindi po tayo ang nagbo-born again sa mga tao. It is the Holy Spirit. Amen. So that's why we must be confident if the Holy Spirit works, and we must acknowledge our nothingness without Him. So that's why in every day of our lives, we must be filled with the Spirit of God. So that when we share the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, there is a strong conviction from the Holy Spirit that will touch the heart of the people. Amen po ba? Amen. And if you will remember, even the Lord Jesus Christ Himself needed to be empowered by the Holy Spirit. Amen. From birth until 30 years old, there is no record in the Bible that Jesus did a miracle until He received the baptism of the Holy Spirit After the baptism of John the Baptist, water baptism of John the Baptist, amen. He received the baptism of the Holy Spirit and he was empowered. Since then, Jesus did supernatural things. Amen. So the same thing with us. If we are not empowered, if we are not anointed by the Holy Spirit, how can we perform extraordinary things? Amen. The Bible says in Mark chapter 16 verse 18, those who believe, these signs will accompany them. When they will drive out demon, they will speak in new tongues. When they lay their hands upon sick people, they will recover. When they pick up snake and drink deadly poison, it will not hurt them at all. Amen. So those signs are the signs of those who believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and being used by the Lord for the advancement of His kingdom. So when you lay your hands upon sick people, they will recover. Ako personally, in my personal experience, I lay hands 3 times a paralytic person and they walk. I experienced 3 times na lumakad ang paralyzed na tao for the glory of God. So, why it was happened? Because the Spirit of God is upon us. It is not because you have a spiritual power. We are not spiritista. We are not albularyo. Amen? But we are anointed by God. That's why when we lay our hands upon sick people, they will recover. I also encountered demon possessed. No? Somebody called me, one of our brother called me, Pastor, can you please go to this address? Because they are badly needed a prayer. They called me and requested if somebody can go to them in their house and pray for that person. So, I go to that house without knowing that the person whom I will pray was a demon possessed. So when I knocked the door, and when the person opened the door, no? Biglang binulagay niya ako, ganun. Bigla na lang, gumano sa akin. Nagulat ako sa ikaw, what happened? So yung pala yung kaharap ko na yung demon possessed na pala siya. Ano? And then I told to the person, come inside. So when we entered the house, I saw that there was 20 person, about 14 person. They cannot stop that person because, you know, he was so strong. So I started to share the gospel to that person. I told him, okay, first, if you really want to be healed, you must receive Jesus in your life as your Lord and personal Savior. And I can help you if you will follow this simple prayer. So I led this guy in the prayer of acceptance. So, of course, without closing my eyes, I looking on him and I saw his hand, no? He put it in his back. And then, all of a sudden, he take his scarf, you know the scarf, yung haba. Yeah. And then, yung pinulungkot niya sa leg ko. And we wrestled. Wrestled the floor. And 14 people na sa loob ng bahay. Wala silang magawa, hindi nila ako matulungan. Nagre-wrestling kami. And then, when I got naka-recover ako, I put my hand in his chest and I said, in Jesus' name! So, he fell down in the floor, no? And he cannot move. So, I started to cast out the demons. And then he was trying to stand, but he cannot. So, he turned his chest on the floor. So, nakadapa na siya ngayon. So, I still put my hands in his back, no? Pinipisip ko pa rin yung likod niya. In Jesus' name, I rebuke that devil spirit inside his body. So, this guy started to move like a snake inside the house. So, kaya ginawa ko, naupo na ako sa baba ko. Ewan, kami! Hindi ko sa bahay, nandun ako naupo ko sa lahat. And praise the Lord, he was delivered, you know. That guy was delivered. And the 14 person inside received also Jesus as their Lord and personal Savior. Amen. So, and not just the only one, but many times I experienced that kind of, battle. But the Bible says our battle is already won. We always won the battle. Amen. Amen. The battle that we are fighting for is already won. Amen. Kaya we need the empowering of the Holy Spirit to accomplish the task that God has given us. Amen po ba?
Amen.
Amen. So, of course, the Holy Spirit uses the church and His people to bring the gospel to the people. Amen po ba?
Amen.
So, that's why we must be excited. Yes, serving God is very challenging. It is not an easy task. But, it is very exciting.
Amen.
Amen. Because, of course, ang dami din namang madaming mga experiences, marami rin kaming mga bloopers sa ministry. Marami rin mga bloopers, kahit sa mga demo process, may mga bloopers. Minsan din, may tumawag sa akin, Pastor, punta ka dito, dalawang chorus na ako. I've already 2 hours in the casting out the demos and still, ayaw pa rin umalis. So, punta kami doon sa, lugar, no? Pagbukas na pito ng, bahay, sabi, wah! Nakalabas naman yung dila ang haba. Parang dito, wala yung tinta yung dila, ano? Tapos nakita ko yung tissue paper, isang ganyan ang iyong kulay itip na gano'n na puno na yung sako ng tissue paper dahil sa laway, ang dami ng laway. Pumunta kami 10 p.m. natapos kami 4 a.m. 6 na oras. Pabalik-balik ang demonyo. No? So, if you are not equipped and empowered by the Holy Spirit, how come that you cannot defeat that negative spirit or demon spirit inside the body of a person? Amen? So, we need the empowering presence of God. Amen po ba?
Amen.
So, we as a church is simply trusting God's word through the Holy Spirit. Amen. Because we are a natural person. Our assignment is extraordinary, supernatural. So that's why we need supernatural being to empower us. And we are called by the Lord. Amen. We are called by the Lord. It is not the pastor, it is not the leader or the ministry heads or our coordinator who called us. It is God Himself who called us. Amen. And the Bible says that many are called but few are chosen. Why? Because in God there is a favoritism. No. We are all called by the Lord, but it is depend on your response to become chosen. You are called, and if you responded to the calling, then you are chosen. Amen. And once you responded to the calling of God, the armory in heaven is available for you. Amen. Amen. So that is the four keys or formulas in explosive church growth. So kung maano po natin yun, then passionate love for God. We serve the Lord out of our love to Him. And of course, pray. We praying leader will surely and a powerful leader. So we need to pray and pray. Amen. And of course, we must also equip and motivate others, not only us, because more people who will do the works with God, there is more accomplishment. Amen po ba? Amen. And lastly, we must trust and be confident in the Holy Spirit's work through your life, in you and through you. Amen. Are you ready?
Amen.
Amen. Sige po, let us all arise and let us once again approach the throne of God. Sige po, let us give our God the best clap of praise. In the book of Isaiah, chapter 4, verse 6, bayon, or chapter 6, verse 4, ang sabi doon, whom shall I send? Who will go for us? And Isaiah answered, Lord, here I am. Send me. The same powerful statement from the Lord in JIL Denmark. If you will just be sensitive to that audible voice from the Lord, that small voice asking for somebody to be sent as a representative of God in this falling world. We are living on the last days, nasa mga huling panahon na po tayo. We are living on the last days. And God is asking for somebody who is willing and available to do the work with God. And if you will respond to that calling from the Lord, the Spirit of God is available to you. In Joel chapter 2 verse 28 says, on the last days, I will pour out my Spirit upon all flesh. Your sons and your daughters will see vision. Your old men will dream dreams. and your young men will prophesy. It was already prophesied that those who will respond to the calling of God, He will make available for him or for her the Spirit of God, the anointing of God that will enable him or her to do the work with God, to fulfill the divine plan and purpose of God in the church. So you are called, and God is counting on you to respond to that calling, to choose the right choice in serving the Creator of the heaven and the earth. The omniscient, the omnipotent God. The God who saves us. The God who loves us. If you are willing, just make your personal covenant with the Lord. It is between you and God. It is not between you and me, or between you and your coordinator or your leaders. It is between you and Him. It is Him personally asking, who shall I send? Who will go for us? Who will go to represent Him? To your family, to your friends, to your neighbors, to your co-workers. That small voice from the Lord. Anak, it is I who called you. Ako ang tumawag sa iyo. It is not an accident, but it is my divine purpose and plan for your life. I want you to represent me in your family, in your friends, in your community, and I want you to make a difference. If you are willing and able and available for the purpose of God, just feel right now the mighty hands of God upon you. He wants to empower you right now. If you are responding to the calling of God, yes, Lord, here I am. Send me. You can sense that mighty task of God from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet. Empowering you, God is enabling you to do the work that will give Him the highest glory and honor, work that will benefit multitude of people. Hallelujah! Oh, we give you praise, God. Just feel the presence of God in our midst. The Spirit of the Lord is hovering upon this place. Oh God, we honor you, Lord God Almighty. We are waiting
presenting ourselves to you, God. We are making our choice. Hallelujah. Just feel wherever you are. Your personal covenant with the Lord, that with the help of the Holy Spirit, by His abounding grace and mercy, you fulfill God's divine purpose and plan by your life. It is not an accident that you are here in this place. It is not an accident that you are here in this nation. God has brought you for a divine purpose and plan. Just allow Him to lead you. Just allow Him to guide you. Just allow Him to bring that plan into fulfillment in your life. Hallelujah. Oh, Jesus.
To my calling is fulfilled.
We will conquer this nation.
announcement for tomorrow po, our Worship and Arts Network leadership training. Our call time is 3 p.m. So those are our workers and music team, so we can have a practice by 3 and then we will proceed for 4 p.m. po. Lingbi, audience by number 1, 2800. In our another sister church in Lingbi po tayo tomorrow. So 3 p.m. po our call time and 4 p.m. po is our reception time, our starting time. Okay po? So of course we will close in prayer. Shall we all arise? And we will do a general prayer na rin po all together. Sabi nga po, a prayer, a leadership church. Amen? A prayer, prayer church. So shall we all hands hold together as we close in prayer? Are we all victorious?
Amen.
Are we fed? Are we energized?
Amen.
May the glory of God?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. So we are all longing for everything, amen? But God wants to do more in His calling in our life because He's the one who called us. So we are victorious in Christ Jesus. Shall we shout hallelujah?
Hallelujah!
Praise the Lord!
Praise the Lord!
Amen and amen. Hallelujah, Lord. Shall we pray? Glory to your name, O God, for all the wonderful things that you have done in our life. And truly, Lord, by the power of your very message, O God, through the life of your son, Pastor Benny, O Lord Jesus, Lord, we thank you for his life. We thank you for his devotion. We thank you for his devoted heart, O Lord God, really to continue, O Lord, what you have started and what you have entrusted into his care, into his life, all the ministry, O God, in Milan, Italy, O Lord Jesus, the whole Italy, Father God, for your glory alone, in Jesus' name. Lord, we pray that continuously cover him, even his family, O Lord God, with manifestation of your Holy Spirit, and continuous blessing, O Lord God, be upon to their life, O Lord, now and forevermore, as they continuously faithfully serving you, and fearfully, O Lord God, be with you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, and even in the life of Sister Angie, O Lord, that she's in Philippines right now, Lord, we pray that I protect them as well, her whole entire family, O Lord God, that continuously be strengthened by you in Jesus' name, O Lord, because of the brothers that pass by, O Lord God. Lord, we pray that you are the one who will take full control of everything. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. And Lord, as we pray tonight, as we hold our hands together, as we put our hearts together, Father God, in one accord, Lord, for the celebrations of the 16th year anniversary of JL Denmark, O Lord God. Lord, we can't do anything apart from you, Father. This is your church. This is your ministry. And you are the one who called us by our name, in Jesus' name. Therefore, Lord, we pray that continuously enlighten us, continuously fire us, O Lord Jesus, with your Holy Spirit. To be alive, O Lord, this majestic spirit be upon us, O Lord God, in serving you more and more, that we will never stop, that we will never turn our back to serve you and to know more in the name of Jesus, because we know and we believe, Father God, that you are preparing us for eternity. You are preparing us for eternity, not only for now, O Lord God, but for the big eternity, the blessings, O Lord, that you are going to give to each one of us according to our faithfulness in serving you, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Lord, strengthen all your workers and leaders, Father God, enlighten us for these few days, O Lord God, that we want to really be with you, Father, and we will be strengthened by you in the name of Jesus. So thank you for everything. Be the programmer of everything, Father God. Prepare all our guests and our pastors, O Lord God, to be with us and be the power of your Holy Spirit, Lord. Lord, we pray for all the first timers Lord, touch them right now in the name of Jesus, that they will not know you for this, for that thing, but they will continuously work out their salvations, oh Lord God, with fear and trembling in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Lord, even each one of us, Father God, all your workers and leaders that really work together, oh Lord God, be a part of this anniversary. Lord, thank you, because from now on, oh Lord God, we know that you are our God. You're always our faithful God, who knew that our labor will never be in vain, O Lord God, in your name, in Jesus' name. Lord, we thank you and bless all our brothers and sisters, all the ministry, O Lord God, and all churches, all Christian churches, full gospel churches, all JIL churches all over the world, Father God. Lord, let your anointing continuously manifest in each churches, O Lord God, with an overflowing fear in God, O Lord God, in doing these things, because in you we never fail, O Lord God, but we are victorious in Christ Jesus, whom we love and whom we serve. Hallelujah, Father, thank you for everything, O Lord God, and Lord, keep us safe and sound in serving you more and more in the name of Jesus. Lord, bless all the ministry, Juan, Khan, San, CDN, oh Lord God. Lord, for your glory. Lord, for your glory, what we are doing, oh Lord Jesus, that we will be enlightened by you, that this mission is for you, oh Lord God, that this mission is for our life, oh Lord God. Thank you for the crown of life that you have given unto us. Thank you, Lord, for the freedom. Thank you, Lord, for the salvations, oh Lord God, so that we will use it for your glory alone. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. And Lord, we pray that continuously bless us beyond more expectations. What we need, Father God, what the secret petitions of your people, what the longings, oh Lord God, work everything, Visa, Father God, you know everything, what is in our heart. Nothing is hidden from you, oh Lord God. Therefore, Lord, we thank you because you are the God who give us in the right timing according to your will and according to your purpose. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Lord, we declare the victory. Victory through victory, O Lord God, for everything what you have done in the lives of your people and your children, Father God. Lord, help us to continuously do the mission to declare the gospel to all nations, O Lord God, in baptizing them in the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, O Lord God, by the power of our Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, we thank you for the victory. Bless Israel, Italy, Denmark, Poland, O Lord God, and even Denmark and Philippines, Lord, bless your people.
Amen.
And even, Father God, in UAE, Father God, in America, oh Lord Jesus, in Asia, in Africa, oh Lord Jesus, bless for your children whom you are using to mission and to share the gospel and the good news all over the world. Lord, help us to reach more souls for you in Christ Jesus. Lord, we thank you even for the food that we are going to partake, that we eat together and gather together. Father God, bless this food. And Lord, we pray that bless your children, so Lord God, whom you use, always bless the works of their hands in Jesus' name. Lord, to you all the praises, to you all the glory. And as we depart in this place, O Lord God, may the love of the Father, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. This we pray. Amen, amen, amen. Amen. Praise God.